Is it important to hit the AI or adequate intake for total omega-6?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Okay, Margaret Okuzumi has a question. The paid chronometer app has a nutrient balance meter for omega-6 to omega-3. I know you've said non-vegans don't need to worry about omega-6, omega-3 balance, but is there a danger to too much omega-3 compared to omega-6 or insufficient omega-6 intake? On my current diet, paleo reset, I'm regularly exceeding the AI for omega-3, but I'm not often reaching the minimum AI for omega-6 unless I make a really concerted effort to, say, eat sunflower seeds or large quantities of nuts. Or should I not worry about that because any normal sort of diet should actually have sufficient linoleic acid? I don't think chronometer database is missing much omega-3 or omega-6 data for the vegetables and fruits I eat because many of the entries are showing very minute quantities of one or the other. Should I strive to at least meet the AI for omega-6 if I have chronic disease or inflammation? After reading through the vitamins and minerals sections for omega-6 or omega-3, I'm thoroughly confused. My diet is not low fat, generally 30 to 45% fat, but most of my fat intake is monounsaturated at present. I need to stay away from consuming lots of saturated fats because it makes my cholesterol levels skyrocket. All right. Thank you for your question, Margaret. Basically, the omega-6 to omega-3 ratio is something that is entirely pertaining to getting these oils from plants. And that's because converting... So the physiologically essential form of omega-6 that you need is arachidonic acid. The physiologically essential form of omega-3 that you need is DHA. And there is, you know, EPA, my stance is sort of controversial on, but I think EPA has some positive pharmacological benefits in certain circumstances, such as lowering triglycerides or treating certain psychiatric disorders, particularly anxiety and depression. But I don't believe that EPA is an essential fatty acid in humans. And when I say essential, I'm talking about physiologically essential, meaning there's going to be a deficiency syndrome if it's not there. So the purpose here is to get enough DHA and arachidonic acid into your tissues. If you are eating fatty fish and egg yolks, and obviously you have to eat enough. So let's say if you're eating 2 servings of fatty fish a week and you are eating 2 egg yolks a day, you probably don't need to worry about the omega-6, omega-3 ratio or meeting the AI for omega-6 to omega-3. Because remember, what is an AI? An adequate intake is defined as the median or mean intake of an apparently healthy population. So an AI is sort of like, we couldn't come up with a number, so we looked at what people were doing and we said it was good. that's what an AI is. So, you know, as we were talking about earlier on overconsumption of omega-6 oils, people are probably consuming too much omega-6. And so if you're not meeting the AI, it's not surprising you wouldn't meet the AI. Like, what? You probably shouldn't meet the AI for omega-6 fatty acids. You know, you probably should regularly exceed the AI for omega-3 fatty acids because generally, you know, our population doesn't consume enough omega-3s. So I think it's totally normal to not meet the AI for omega-6 and to exceed the AI for omega-3. Question is really, if you have, you know, if you have systemic inflammation going on, you know, you frame this as, should I strive to at least meet the AI for omega-6 if I have chronic disease / inflammation? Well, if you have chronic disease / inflammation, you might be depleting your omega-6, which means depleting arachidonic acid, which means you might need more arachidonic acid. So does that mean you should meet the AI for linoleic acid? Not really, it means that you need more arachidonic acid. And so one way to get more arachidonic acid, if you have good conversion from linoleic acid, is to eat more linoleic acid. But you're probably going to get better bang for your buck by eating more egg yolks or more liver. And after that, you're probably going to get more bang for the buck out of supplementing with arachidonic acid derived from the mushroom. If you search Amazon for arachidonic acid, you'll find supplements like that. And after that, you're going to get somewhat less bang for the buck, but still a lot more than hitting the AI for linoleate. You're going to get, you know, somewhat less bang for the buck out of evening primrose and barrage oil supplements. You know, and then after that, way down at the bottom, yeah, you would probably get more arachidonic acid at some point from linoleic acid. So, you know, what you should probably do is get like omega quant fatty acid profile and look and see whether your arachidonic acid levels are good. A big profile that I like, Genova Ion Panel also has plasma fatty acid analysis. You can also get plasma fatty acids from Quest. But omega quant does them in phospholipids, which is ideal. So if you get their full fatty acid profile and look at the arachidonic acid specifically to see if it's in range, if it's depleted, you need more arachidonic acid. If you need more arachidonic acid, you can get it through the ways I just ran through. If your arachidonic acid levels look good, you shouldn't worry at all about meeting the AI for linoleate, as far as I'm concerned. So I hope that helped, Margaret. Thank you for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.